Welcome to Food Talk with Chiru. In this month of Jan, when we are doing this entire series on balanced eating and smart choices towards what we eat and what we are putting into our body, today's recipe is that of a pasta. So Parina, can you tell us more about what this pasta is and what makes it different from our regular pasta that we eat?
This pasta has fish.
Okay, so that's different.
So that's different. It also has a pesto in it.
Okay. So well, I have a pesto sauce recipe already shared.
Oh, fantastic. So let's use that and get this going. Also, it requires minimal cooking. It's something that needs to be assembled off the heat.
Okay.
And
so is it served cold? Is it a cold pasta?
No, it's served warm, but it is not cooked while it's assembled.
Okay. So. And anyway, is it okay? Because we are adding pesto, so you don't want to cook it on the heat. Okay, great.
Neither do I want to cook the tuna.
Okay.
So when, you know, the can that you get in the market where you get tuna and brine, I want to use that and I want to keep it raw.
And you don't need to cook it?
You don't need to cook it.
Great. So that's new information, a new piece of knowledge. So let's quickly get started. Before we do that, don't forget to subscribe to Food Talk with Sharon and please do follow us both on our Instagram handles, Food Talk with Sharon and
Nakey.in.
So what is the first step for this pasta?
First of all, we have to put a little bit, just like a couple of drops of olive oil into a non-stick pan and saute the tomato from that.
Okay. And we're using cherry tomatoes.
We're using cherry tomatoes. They should be sliced into two. And you should cook them until they're slightly soft so that they still hold their own.
Okay. And if we don't have cherry tomatoes, then the regular tomatoes.
This is fine too.
Yeah. So now that the tomatoes are done, so next is the onions, I guess?
Yes, so we add a little more oil, just another drops again, a couple of drops, and we add the onion and the garlic to it and ensure that the onion turns a translucent pink color. And then it's just ready to go. Don't add anything to it, just cook it and put it aside. So now what we will do is, we will actually create the sauce for this pasta.
Okay.
Off the stove.
Okay. Okay. Great.
So why don't you do the honors? Let's start with putting the onions in first.
So that's the onions and the garlic.
Yes.
Okay. So this is now drained. So this was tuna in brine.
Yeah,
not the oil one.
I prefer using the one in brine. It's lesser fat and it's anyway a very low fat fish.
So we just mix this?
Yeah, we mix this. We also add the pesto sauce to this.
So the recipe of pesto sauce is already there on my site. You can refer to that. Now for making this, we have reduced the quantity of oil. So that recipe of pesto requires about 3 tablespoons of olive oil. Instead, I've just used a teaspoon and then I've used a little bit of water to make sure that it grinds well.
So let's just mix this all together. The next step is to add some salt and pepper. Now to this, we will add our olives.
Okay.
One by one. And there are the green ones. So lots of olives.
Okay.
Okay. Now what we can do is, we can just add the pasta. So what we have to ensure, Sharon, when we mix this after adding the pasta, is the pasta is coated with this entirely. If at any stage you feel that this is dry, the options are to use another couple of grams of olive oil, or we are using some pasta water.
Yeah, so you can reserve the water in which you've cooked the pasta.
It takes a bit of time to coat the pasta properly with the tuna. So spend that time mixing. The last step is to add the cooked tomatoes. The reason why we didn't add this earlier is because they turn mush if you mix too much. So just a light stir after everything is mixed together. There you go, it's ready.
That's it. So that was a really easy recipe.
It's really simple and nutritious.
You just don't need anything else to go with it. This by itself is a full balanced meal.
Yes.
Yes, I'm learning the words here.
You can find the macros on Food Talk with Sharon, obviously.
So I would be sharing the macros for this on my website. You can check out the recipe.